Good evening, everybody. My name is Kazuyuki Nakazato. Kaz Nakazato is here. I'm from Okinawa Prefecture, in Japan. Everybody know Okinawa? I'm from Okinawa Prefecture DC office.
Thank you so much. The other guy's up.
Please do. And thank you very much for your opportunities. And I'm very happy to be here today. I would like first to thank WorldBeyondWar for inviting our office and allowing me to speak. And Okinawa Prefecture DC office was established in 2015, and our missions are to disseminate information about Okinawa situation in Okinawa regarding U.S. military bases issues, and facilitate discussion between Okinawa and the United States governments, congressional leaders, think tanks, university organizations, and people like you all, so that we are working toward better mutual understanding of the issues and creating better solutions through these discussions. So I'm very excited today, and maybe today's topic is eliminate nukes, not life in Europe on ours, and maybe some of the topics I speak is a little bit off the conversation, but I hope you understand the situation of Okinawa. So let me talk about today's topic from the perspective of Okinawa, a part of Japan with a different background from the rest of Japan. For those of you who are not familiar with Okinawa, let me briefly give some idea. Okinawa located at the southernmost tip of Japan, but in the middle of Japan, East Asia, and Southeast Asia, and was an independent state known as Ryukyu Kingdom, or Ryukyu Kingdom. For 450 years from its establishment in 1429 and its incorporation as a prefecture of Japan in 1879. The kingdom flourished thanks to vibrant trade and active relations with Japan, China, and Southeast Asia. Through commerce and interaction with neighboring countries, we created unique and original culture and absorbing various and diverse influences. In addition, the islands of Okinawa are known for beautiful beach resorts and abundant nature with such as coral reefs and unique wildlife. And last year, UNESCO announced the addition of natural sites in Okinawa and the neighboring islands to the World Heritage List for their high biodiversity value. With these attractions, Okinawa is now one of Japan's most popular tourist destinations. Before the pandemic, we have an annual visitor count reached 10 million. It's about the same as Hawaii. The Okinawa's economy was booming mainly through tourism, taking advantage of the fact that the islands are favorably situated in the center of East Asia and Japan. But Okinawa's geographical location has brought challenges throughout its history. Once independent kingdom of Ryukyu, Okinawa went through annexation and assimilation into Japan. And the decades after becoming part of Japan, the people of Okinawa were thrown into a frames of major international war. In the aftermath, Okinawa was placed under the U.S. military control for 27 years, and it was finally reverted to Japanese sovereignty in 1972. So 1945 to 1972, we were under U.S. control for 27 years. During the Battle of Okinawa in World War II, fierce fighting between Japan and the United States and Allied forces took place on the islands. People describe it as the typhoon of steel, reducing the islands to literally ashes. Battle of Okinawa resulted in the death of over 200,000 people.